brought to you by Penguin.
On the Edge by Sarah Turner. Read by Florence Howard. For J, H, J, and W. Team Turner. Always. Kiss. Prologue. Sue created the group Nana's Week of Fun. Sue added Joni. Sue added Nick. Sue added Kate. Sue added Michael. Sue added Ali. Sue. Hello, everyone. My grandson helped me set this group up, so I hope we've done it right. Before Phyllis passed, she asked me to assist her with something she'd been planning for some time. I have a message from her about next week and the scattering of her ashes. Kate. What the... Sue. Before we begin, can everybody hear me? Michael. We can hear you, Sue. Ali. Hi, Sue. Nick. Nobody can hear you, Sue. It's not a séance. Sue. Make sure you have added everyone, Sue. Sue. Sorry, I wasn't meant to post that bit here. That was the start of Phyllis's instructions. Kate. Instructions? What is going on? Sue posted a gif. Nick. Is that Ryan Reynolds? Sue. I didn't post that. Kate. You did. Not that I'm complaining. Love a bit of the Reynolds. Sue. Are we all here now? I think we're just waiting for Joni. Nick. She's here. There are two blue ticks, which means everyone has read your message. I need to pick Stan up from school in a minute, so can you just tell us what's going on? Michael. Are you there, Joni love? Sue has a message from Nana. Ali. Is Phyllis okay? Is she at peace? Nick. It's not a message from the grave, Mum. Jesus. Kate. Can you just tell us, please? Sue. Okay, I'll copy and glue it. Bear with. Sue. Hello, my darlings. If you are reading this, Sue has managed to assemble you all in one place. Thank you, Sue. You always were a good friend. This message is for Michael, Ali, Joni, Nick, and Kate. It's important that you all read it. I am sorry to have to do this, as I know you may not be best pleased with what I have arranged, but I have my reasons, and I don't think any of you are able to argue with me, now that I am dead. Next week, the five of you, plus young Stan, will stay together at my house. I have added a couple of days to the long weekend you had all agreed to be at for my 90th birthday celebrations. I have devised an itinerary for your week, and you will be presented with your first activity on your arrival at the pub next Friday. In order for my will to be read and my ashes to be released, you must all stay for the full week and complete a number of activities. Tasks, if you will, though they will be fun. I never wanted it to come to this, but my attempts to bang your heads together over recent years have proved futile, and this is, I suppose, my parting shot. If you don't complete the week, there will, with regret, be no inheritance for anyone, other than Kat's protection, and my ashes will remain with Sue. I would rather that my final resting place was somewhere other than the top of Sue's television, particularly when she watches so much bargain hunt. But it is a risk I am willing to take. If it comes to it, at least I know the cats will be all right. Joni, I know that you particularly are not going to like this, and I am sorry for that. I love you, and I want what is best for you. I hope that in time, you will find it in yourself to forgive me. I have left Sue four more messages to share with you at specific times during the week. But for now, it's goodbye from me. With love, Nana Phyllis. Kate. Was she on crack? Nick. What does she mean? She's devised an itinerary. Ali. An awful lot of thought has gone into this, by the sounds of it. Nick. Did you know about this, Michael? Michael. I had no idea. This has caught me completely off guard. Ali. What shall we do? Nick. It doesn't sound like we have much choice, does it? Kate. You're very quiet, at Joni. Nick. She's not going to do it, obviously. She won't want to spend a week with us. Kate. Of course she's going to do it. It's not just her inheritance at stake, it's all of ours. Kate. And Nana being laid to rest, of course. Which is more important. R.I.P. Michael. Are you there, Joni, love? Joni has left the group. Chapter 1. There are two types of people in the world. The planners, who like to organise things with plenty of notice. These are the people who book tickets and sort travel and generally oversee life's admin. Spoiler alert, I am one of these people. I like nothing more than a plan. Plans save lives. Then there are the people who say things such as, "Shall we play it by ear?" or "Let's go with the flow." Lewis falls into this second group, which is why him overseeing tonight's anniversary date night planning has set my nerves on edge. I'm not good with the flow. The flow could meander anywhere, and in my experience, no good has ever come from meandering. If you're thinking, "I bet she's fun at parties," you would be right. I am not very fun at parties. Truth be told, I spend a lot of time worrying that I'm not very fun at all. It's such a tricky quality to cultivate, funness. And I suspect the fact that I once Googled how to be fun means I can't exactly be bursting with joie de vivre. The more fun you try to be, the less fun you seem. I haven't always been quite so unfun, but that's a longer story. The sort of tale that lends itself to a Lift the Flap children's book. The woman who lost her fun. Is it hiding under the bed? No. Is it buried beneath years of heartache and resent? Do you think they used a stunt double for that bit on the bridge? Lewis brings me back to the moment. He's holding the door for me as we exit the cinema. I saw an interview recently where he said he did a lot of his own stunts. I can't imagine he did that one. What do you think? He taps me on the arm. Joni? My eyes adjust to the evening light, my brain catching up with his post-film commentary. Probably not that one, no. The motorbike flips were insane. And that bit where the bus is on fire and the motorbike flies over the top. He puffs out his cheeks. Incredible. Mm-hmm. My mind wandered from the machine guns and motorbike stunts around 20 minutes in, fretting instead over the unhinged group chat I was added to by my Nana's friend Sue last week. What's being proposed is completely insane. A family week of fun, with people who are mostly not my real family, doing things that will almost certainly be no fun at all, even when I'm exerting my maximum fun effort. I tried to leave the chat altogether, but Sue was having none of it, re-adding me, then sending a separate private message, laying the guilt on thick. It was so important to Phyllis that everyone got involved, love. It's blackmail, that's what it is. I'm not even sure it's legal to bribe people who typically avoid each other to spend time together in order to release your will or ashes, but evidently Nana wasn't going to let that stop her. Shy of faking illness or injury, I can't see how I'm going to get out of it. I knew you'd enjoy it. Lewis nudges me with his elbow. You can't beat those sort of action sequences. Well, it's not really my sort of film. No, But you enjoyed it. So... He smiles triumphantly. It was definitely the best thing they were showing. Right. I don't point out the poster behind him for the new South Korean tragicomedy everyone's been raving about. I knew the chances of him booking tickets to that one were slim, as he doesn't do subtitles. But I've said many times that I don't really do action. Are you hungry?
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.